हरिओम एंड गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू द फैसिनेटिंग वर्ल्ड ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. दिस मॉर्निंग आई शैल एक्सप्लेन इन डिटेल द फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ द लेसन, द थर्ड लेवल, रिटन बाय जैक फिनी. एज वी क्विकली रिकैपिटुलेट वॉट वी हैव लर्न सो फार, वी रिमेंबर द स्ट्रेंज एक्सपीरियंस द चार्ली, the protagonist or main character of the story, has had. An in-depth understanding of the story will enable us to unravel the mystery behind the strange experience that Charlie has at the Grand Central Station. The narration begins in a kind of mock serious tone. It seems the presidents of the New York Central and the New York New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear or will give us solid proof of the fact that there exists only two levels in the Grand Central Station. Now, who are these presidents of the railroads? They are obviously the people in authority or power who control and govern the entire railway system. Our narrator, Charlie says that he has taken the obvious step, that is, he has had the rare opportunity of transporting himself to the third level. He is thoroughly convinced and is very confident about it. When he narrates this experience, his psychiatrist friend Sam Weiner dismisses or concludes that Charlie is sad, depressed, and wants to escape from the rat race of the present modern world. He looks at it as a kind of escapism or a product of his imagination. Now, Charlie's wife Louisa feels very sad. Sam further explains that it is quite natural for Charlie to entertain such desires because the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and the like. It appears to be an all-pervasive feeling, that is, everybody wishes to escape. But Charlie refuses to accept that he is an escapist. He strongly believes in the existence of the third level. Charlie's friends concur with Sam, that is, they fully agree with him that Charlie is an escapist. They also claim that his hobby of collecting stamps is a proof of his temporary refuge from reality. Charlie argues, saying that he has inherited this hobby from his grandfather, who lived during the good old times when life was more peaceful. Charlie tells us what had happened. After a hectic work schedule at the office one evening, he is in a hurry to reach home. Wanting to board the train, he goes to the Grand Central Station, New York, where there are only two levels. Charlie confesses with absolute simplicity and honesty that he is a very ordinary person leading a peaceful life. He describes his attire. He wears a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy band. He goes to the Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue to the first level, then walks to the second level and ducks into an arched doorway, heading for a subway, and gets lost. Actually, he has transported himself many times in the past to different worlds of his own creation. He says there are many avenues and corridors in Grand Central Station that are quite challenging and inviting to be explored. Through one of these portals, he meanders into the 1890s. We recall here his interest in philately, which helps him to keep the past alive and resolve the intricacies caused by the intervening of fantasy and reality. Charlie says the corridors keep on opening up and he keeps on walking, leading him to the much desired third level. The only sound that he hears are that of his footsteps. He is the only commuter through those corridors. When he reaches an open space, He could hear the co-mingling of voices in the air, which means that people are talking continuously. He's sure that this place is absolutely different when compared to what he has seen in the first and the second level. The rooms are smaller with fewer ticket windows and train gates. Everything around him looked quite old-fashioned. The lights are flickering and dim, outmoded old-fashioned gas lights. We move along with Charlie as he observes the things and people in the third level that existed only in Charlie's imagination. He talks about brass spittoons on the floor. Spittoons are containers used for spitting. A man pulls out a gold watch from his pocket to see the time. He then describes the clothes worn by the men and women of the 1890s. The men wear derby hat, that is a hat which is a hard felt hat with a rounded crown, originally created by the London hat makers. He had a handlebar mustache. A woman is wearing a dress with leg-off mutton sleeves, that means tight-fitting sleeves, skirts to the top of her high-buttoned shoes. Here, Charlie spots a locomotive, Carrier and Ives, with a funnel-shaped stack. He is now thoroughly convinced that he has travelled to the past. He also sees the popular newspaper, The World, with a lead story of President Cleveland, dated June 11, 1894. In sheer excitement, Charlie moves to the ticket window, hoping to get two tickets so as to reach Galesburg, where he has spent his childhood days. But he realizes that he would be jailed because he has only the modern currency. This is when he bounces back to reality. Here we have now come to the end of part one. We shall analyze in detail the last part of the story in our next video lesson, my dear children. Until then, bye-bye. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much. Happy learning. Keep smiling. Hari Om.